my way with God. Oh, fill my way every day with love. Oh, as I walk with the heavenly dawn, let me go all the while with the song and the smile. Fill my way every day. Let me go all the while with a song and a smile. Fill my way every day with love.
Hallelujah! Glory be to God. How many are happy to be in the house of God? Amen. Day 4. Hallelujah. The Lord Jesus is here with us, and we are so happy to have Apostle Isaacson McLaughlin from the Spoken Word Tabernacle in Dodowa, Ghana, amen, to come for take two, right? Round two, hallelujah. How many are happy and expecting God to bless us tonight? Hallelujah. Well, without much further ado, let me welcome Apostle Isaacson, amen, to the 2023 Message Believers Global Convention. And we want to thank all our translators and all the churches who have dialed in to hear the message. Let's go again. Fill my way every day with love. Oh, as I walk with the
read my way every day with love. Read my way every day with love. As I walk in the heavenly door, all the while with a song and a smile, be my way every day in life. Praise be the name of the Lord. I want us to sing a special song, then read the scriptures. When I get to the end of the way. How many of you know how to sing it? Amen. The sun having washed in the footprints of the stranger on Galilee shore. Hallelujah. The sun has been washed in the footprint of the stranger on Galilee shore. And the voice that's a will be heard in Judea, yeah, no more. By the path of the lowly Galilee, with joy I will follow today. And the toys of the road will sing nothing. When I get to the end of the way, there are so many hills to climb up the wall. appoints me my pathway, knows just what is needful and bad. Oh, I know in his word he can promise. Oh, that my strength, it shall be as my day, and the toys of the road will seem not in. When I get to the end of the way, oh, to forsake me.
Hallelujah.
Oh, give me a try too much. Oh, his people are yelling pages. Satan can never cleanse us. Oh, by and by I shall see him and praise him. Oh, in the city of God and of the road will say nothing. Oh yes, when I get to the end of the way, oh, when the last feeble steps have been taken, oh, and the gate of the city appeared. Oh, and the beautiful songs of the angels, oh, flowed out of my lips. And I sing so sweet tears. Oh, you'll be bright as clear as the day. And the toil,
hallelujah,
of the rose in that day. When I get to the end of the way, oh, then the toys of the road will seem nothing. When I get,
he loves me so well to forsake me.
Oh, he loves me too well to forsake me. Oh, give me one try too much.
Hallelujah!
Oh, all is peace.
I'm the yelling pigeon. Oh, and Satan can never cleanse us. Oh, by and by I shall see him and praise him. Oh, in the sea, all the earth and the day. Oh, and the toys of the road save my name. To the end of the way. Oh, and the voice of the road will say, Mary, when I get to the end of
glory be to God. Let us turn our Bibles to the book of Genesis, chapter 15. Genesis, chapter 15, verse 1. Genesis, chapter 15, verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, Fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what would thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus? And Abraham said, Lord, and Abraham said, Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in my house is mine here. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be thine here, but he that shall come forth out of thy own bowels shall be thine heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now toward heaven and tell the stars if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it unto him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of Ur of Chaldees to give thee this land to inherit it. And he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? And he said unto him, Take me an heifer of 3 years old, and a she-goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. And he took unto him all these, and divided them in the midst, and laid each piece one against another, but the birds divided he not. And when the fowls came upon the carcass, Abram drove them away. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abram, and lo, an horror of great darkness fell upon him. And he said unto Abram, Know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in the land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them for 400 years. And also the nation whom they shall serve will I judge, and afterwards shall they come out with great substance. And thou shalt go to thy fathers in peace, thou shalt be buried in the good old age. But in the fourth generation, Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you this night for your grace and mercies that has brought us together. Lord, the toils of this world will seem nothing when we get to the end of the road. Thank you for the inspiration given to Pastor Samuel to call for this convention. Thank you for the saints of God that are watching online all across India, Philippines, Africa, everywhere, at midnight, in the morning, at late night. The translators that are doing their best, Lord, I pray your blessings upon them. Bless the keynote speakers. We thank you for the safe traveling message of Pastor Chandler in Toronto. Lord, we are praying, believing that you will join us tomorrow. We thank you for bringing Pastor Fenafit also before us, Lord. Even Brother Steve yesterday, Lord, brought them together. Father, we are grateful. Lord, we pray that tonight, once again, you will pass by this way. Let the angel of the Lord visit every seat, O God, from every home to every home. O God, I pray, do not pass us by. Meet each and every one of us at the point of our knees. At the end, be careful to give you thy glory, thy praise, and thy honor. Give us our sins, our trespasses, our shortcomings, and our transgressions. Father, your servant is reporting to duty. Take me out of the way and have your own way, and speak to the knees of thy people, that we can rejoice in the things that you have revealed. Rebuke every powers of darkness. We bring under subjection every foul spirit that is here to spoil upon our liberty. Give us freedom to preach that word, and give us freedom to receive that word. We thank you, Lord, for this day. These and many other blessings do we pray and ask and receive in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Shall we humbly be seated? I greet you all tonight in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, back home we are used to preach with interpreters. So when we speak, they also speak. And we get inspiration from there. So when you go somewhere without an interpreter, your mind is psyched. You are trying to hear somebody speak. But I believe the Holy Ghost is the interpreter. Amen and amen. Once again, I'm happy to come by this way. God bless you, Pastor Samuel, for the honor given unto me. And thank you for the acquaintances and the fellowship we have been having. I want to welcome Pastor Fernand once again. May the Lord bless you. And Pastor Steve, may God bless you. And our brethren and friends that are watching online, I bring greetings from Pastor Moses Duka in Ghana, Pastor Ebenezer Wate. And the Lord's saints are sending forth their greetings in Nigeria, in Malawi, in Kenya. They say, greet them for us. Hallelujah. And I believe they are praying along with us. So the Lord will help us tonight. We want to talk about the royal seed of Abraham. You know, the last time we had a lot of scriptures and quotes to read. Amen. But tonight will be a little different. But we will still read more. I'm not used to slides and whatever it is. But I told them yesterday, we are going to read a lot of scriptures, so when I mention, they will be able to project it. So you go along with me. Amen. How many of you were blessed yesterday? Yes. Do you appreciate Pastor Lonan? Yes. That was a great message. Amen and amen. We can see the Spirit of God is moving among the bride. Amen. Last Sunday, when the servant of God was preaching, he picked some notes of the Monday service. Amen. Yesterday, when Pastor Lonan was preaching, he picked some note of Pastor David. He showed me, he said, this is what I preach in the U.S. I said, that is God at work. Amen. Amen. And I don't know whether somebody's note will be picked also tomorrow. Amen and amen. So we are blessed by the story of Joseph, perfection. And today we are going through the life of Abraham, the royal seed of Abraham. So I would like to give a little background so that we'll build upon as the Lord helping us. Those who are having their pen and writing, maybe you can jot something down. You go home, you go and study over it. Amen. The calling of Abraham was in Genesis chapter 12. Amen. In Genesis chapter 12, God called Abraham. Amen. God was raising another generation by the calling of Abraham. Amen. When God called him, he was not Abraham. He was Abram. Hallelujah. And Abram was an idol worshiper or idolater. Are we together? He was an idol worshiper when God called him. God did not call Abram because he was a good man. He called him when he was worshiping the idols of his father. Amen and amen. I believe the little ones are here, so we're doing a little demonstration tonight so that they catch along with us. Amen. Imagine when God called Abraham, he was at the age of 75 years. And the Lord told him, I want to send you to a strange country, and I will bless you and thy seed after you. Oh, glory be to God. God promises Abraham two things. He promises him blessings of his seed, and he promises him this land. Keep that together as we travel along. Amen. Imagine one day Abraham wake up and say, honey, Sarah, I'll be hearing a strange voice. Say, what was that voice? That voice said we should leave our land and go to some land. Maybe Sarah might ask, is it Canada? No. America? No. Which land? The voice said, a land that I will show you. Why don't you tell us a land so that we can see it in a map and know whether we are passing Upper Canada Village or we want to pass Quebec? He said, no. See, the calling of Abraham is the beginning of Christianity. Amen. Amen. That is the foundation of Christianity. For Abraham to obey that voice and to move out of the father's house from among his kindred and his nation, he have to move by faith. And as Christians, we don't walk by sight. As Christians, we walk by faith. And as Christians, we don't choose by sight. As Christians, we choose by faith. Amen. We walk by faith. We choose by faith. And without faith, no one can please God. Hallelujah. So they began on a journey. When God called Abraham, he called him from among his family, from his kindred, and from his nation. Praise be the name of the Lord. Are we together, church? And when God called him, as usual, he gathered the family along. He took Lot, his nephew, took his father, Terah, and they all went in the journey. Then in Genesis 13, there was a contention between Lot's herdsmen and the herdsmen of Abraham. Are we together, church? Yes. So what happened? Abraham is a man of peace. As much as a Christian does not strive, a Christian does not struggle, not for anything in the world. Abraham said, we are brothers. Why do we struggle? Why do we strive? Now, if you choose west, I will go east. If you choose north, I will go south. We should not fight. So in Genesis 13, there was a separation between Abraham and Lot. But you see, God called Abraham, but not Lot. It was Abraham who heard the voice, but not Lot. And unfortunately, Lot couldn't recognize the source of his blessing. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. If Lot could have recognized the source of his blessing, he would not leave Abraham. Amen and amen. But he was following Abraham for following sake. Like many of us follow our fathers to church. Young ones, we follow our parents to church because they don't pay our school fees if we don't go to church. We follow our husband to church. If I don't go to church, my husband will not love me anymore. So I follow my husband to church. You call it follow, follow. That does not help anyone. Lord needed a personal revelation just like Abraham had. Praise be the name of the Lord. I trust that we will hear from God personally during this convention. Hallelujah. We don't need a second-handed rope. We need our personal revelation, our personal encounter with the Lord. Glory be to God. So what happened? There was a separation. And Lot chose or pitched his tent towards Sodom. He chose where it was greenish, flourishing. Oh my God. And Abraham stayed in a plain land. And even on the plain land, God still blessed Abraham. Praise be the name of the Lord. Do you know what happened? When Lot chose that place he chose, there was a trouble. Another king came and invaded the place. And Lot was taken captive. Are we getting together? And when Lot was taken captive, and Abraham heard it, Abraham did not rejoice over Lot. In Genesis 14, Abraham rescued Lot. In Genesis 12, it was a calling of Abraham. In Genesis 13, Abraham separated from Lot. Then in Genesis 14, Abraham rescued Lot. He gathered his household. They were not trained men. He gave them kitchen life. Let us go and rescue Lot. What was that? That was the spirit of Christ in display. Amen. It takes the spirit of Christ to stand in the gap for one another. Amen. Hallelujah. The children of Israel sinned, and God was willing to smite them and raise another generation. He said, Moses, stand aside. Let me clear these guys off. I will raise another generation. Moses came and stood in the gap. He said, Lord, this is not what you told me. You didn't bring us from Egypt to come and die here. You brought us out to take us somewhere. And God looked upon Moses. The Creator looked upon his creation and repented. Glory. Hallelujah. He could not bypass Moses. Because Moses caught his word back to him. And God is obligated to his word. Amen. Hallelujah. God is not obligated to you. He is obligated to his word. So if you hold him by his word, he's obligated to you. Glory, hallelujah. So he healed him by his word. And in this end time, before the great and the dreadful day of the Lord, there is another man on the scene. Hallelujah. In this last days, in this last generation, that without the ministry of that man, we will be cursed. God have to send Malachi 4 to stand in the gap for us again. Hallelujah. And he preached a message, standing in the gap. That was the spirit of Christ on display. So what did he do? He stood in a gap and rescued Lot. Are we together? Now in Genesis chapter 15, the Lord's scriptures that we read. But before then, when he went to rescue Lot, the same 14, at the end of Genesis 14, when Abraham went to rescue Lot, and when he was returning from the rescue of Lot, he met a man. Glory. Hallelujah. A man without the beginning of days, nor the ending of life. Hallelujah. He met Melchizedek, the great high priest. Oh, glory be to God. And Abraham paid the tenth, the tithe of all the spoils that he received unto him. And that man served him communion, bread and wine. Hallelujah. And he called him, blessed be Abraham, the possessor of the heaven and the earth. Hallelujah. Abraham received a reward of what he did for Lot. And the prophet said, when the battle is over, we shall meet him out there to take another communion. We shall meet him there to take another wedding supper. The Lord's Supper. Amen. And communion is given for overcomers. Praise be the name of the Lord. Communion is given to overcomers. Because Abraham overcame the world. Abraham overcame the kings. So the Lord served him communion. But he looked at Abraham and he called him the possessor of the heaven and the earth. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Possessing all things. Brethren, there is a reward in serving the Lord. Amen. There is a reward in standing in a gap. Amen. The prophet said so many times, when you are praying for one another, you are the one receiving the blessings. Correct. If you know that secret, you always pray for me. You always pray for Pastor Samuel. Because as you are praying for him, you are the one receiving the blessings. Yeah. Yes, sir. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Blessed be Abraham, the possessor of the heaven and the earth. Now, in Genesis 15, can you put it back? Let us read something there. In Genesis 12, that was a calling of Abraham. That is the justification of Abraham. Are we together? Now, in Genesis 15, let us take our time and read. Maybe you go to verse 4. And Abraham is asking the Lord for something, that he need a child to inherit him. And Abraham said, behold, to me thou hast given no seed. Lo, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, this shall not be thy heir, that is Eliezer, but he that shall come out of thy bowels shall be thy heir. And he brought him forth, continue, abroad, and said, look now toward heaven, and tell the stars. Like Pastor Nola was saying yesterday, before they say, look towards the seashore. Can you number the seashore? That is how your sea shall be. Now he said, look towards heaven. Hallelujah. He said, can you see if you can number them? And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. Look at the English word, stars, plural. But thy seed was seed, not seeds. Hallelujah. Are we together? So from the dust to stars. Oh, glory, hallelujah. From the earthly to celestial. From mortality to immortality. Oh, glory be to God. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. Are we together? Abraham believed on the Lord, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of the Chaldeans to give thee this land to inherit it. I told you two things God promised Abraham: the blessings of his seed and the blessings of a land to inherit. Are we together? And he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? And he said unto him, take me an heifer of 3 years old, a she-goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a pigeon, the young pigeon. Now, pause there. What was going to happen there? God was going to establish a covenant with Abraham. Are we together? These animals that you are seeing here, they are sacrificial animals that you can find them in Leviticus 16. But we are not reading that one now. Are we together? Yes. These sacrificial animals are used in cleansing in the Old Testament. Together. Are we together? Yes. Now, let's continue. He said, and he took unto him all these and divided them in the midst. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And laid each other against another. He divided all those animals into two and put the piece against another. But the best divided he not. Amen. Praise be the name of the Lord. The prophet of God says the reason why he did not divide the best is because the best stand for divine healing. Yes. And the animals that he divided and he put the piece upon piece to each other, that was what Old Testament in the New Testament. And Brother Abraham says that healing was in the Old Testament and healing is in the New Testament. Amen. Healing was in the law and healing was in the grace. Amen. So the turtle dove and the long pigeon was commanded not to be divided. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And when the fowls came down upon the carcasses, Abraham drove them away. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abram. Our prophet told us that Abraham was having a vision. And when the deep sleep fell upon Abraham, what happened? A great horror of darkness fell upon him. Abraham fell in a trance. He said that the going down towards of the sun is every man is predestined to go down by death. Death is a window before every man. And a man is predestined to die and go to hell. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. And he said to Abraham, know of a surety that I see shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them for 400 years, and also the nation whom they shall serve will I judge. Continue. And after all, they shall come out with a great substance, and thou shalt go to thy fathers in peace, and shall be buried a good old age, but in the fourth generation they shall come hither again, for the iniquities of the Amorite is not yet full. What was happening? God was sanctifying Abraham. So Genesis chapter 12 was the justification of Abraham. Genesis chapter 15 was a sanctification of Abraham. Because without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Are we together, church? God was showing the pieces, showing together that there is going to be a dispositional change from the law to grace. God was having contract with man. God was making a covenant with man. And Brother Abraham gave us many stories that in Japan, when they make a contract, they throw salt on each other. And then in the Old Testament, when they make a contract, two men will stand here, they will kill an animal and stand between them. And if I don't fulfill my part of the covenant, we'll be dead as the animal. Is that in America or in England or in Canada, after a contract, we shake hands in agreement to the contract. So what happened? When God was making that contract with Abraham, God divided it. It was foreshadowing on the cross of Calvary that God or that animal was a substitute showing the perfect sacrifice, which is Christ Jesus. When he died on the cross, God tore his body from his spirit, took his body on the throne as a memorial. Then God sent back his spirit on the earth. Hallelujah. God sent back part of the contract on the earth. Between the body, he made his soul an offering for men. Hallelujah. So when the body in heaven, on the throne of memorial, and the spirit that is sent on earth, when it comes together, that is a full contract. So in Genesis 15, Abraham was sanctified. Are we together, church? Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. Then in Genesis 16, something happened. Sarah, which was a type of the church, doubted the word of God. And when Sarah doubted the word of God, it produces Ishmael. How did it happen? The woman, which is a church, the church always type a woman. He told Abraham, are you sure this promise will come to pass? Or maybe my husband, you were dreaming. Anyway, Hagar is here. He's a young woman. I am past age. Maybe you can take him and it to fulfill what God told you. We don't know, or we are not the one to tell how God to bring his word to pass. Because God has a provided way in everything. Even in this end time, God has a provided way. We don't know how to tell God how best to run his business. God has a better plan to run his business. Hallelujah. And the purpose of God concerning our life is what will stand. Regardless of how we try to fix it ourselves, it is the purpose of God that will stand. Are we together, church? So the woman preached another message to him. And instead of Abraham believing and obeying the voice of God in his age, Abraham listened to the church, Sarah the wife. And when he listened to the church, he created an unbelief. Because the church is not a mouthpiece of God. And when unbelief comes in, it produces unbelief. And the prophet of God said, if you doubt the word of God and substitute it for anything else, it becomes a thorn in your flesh. I don't want to dwell much in Genesis 16. Now let us go to Genesis 17. I think it's good we read there. Genesis 12 was justification of Abraham. Genesis 15 was sanctification of Abraham. Then Genesis 17 is the baptism of Holy Ghost of Abraham. Can you just... Sorry for the interpreters. We will get together along. Genesis chapter 17. And when Abraham was 90 years old and nine, the Lord appeared to him and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and I will multiply thee exceedingly. And Abraham fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. God called Abraham a father of many nations when he had no evidence to show. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Brothers, don't care how people see you. Be interested how God sees you. If you don't care how you see yourself, just be interested how God sees you. Because it's how God sees you that is what matters. Hallelujah. Abraham had no child to prove himself, but God called him a father of many nations. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. Neither shall thy name anymore be called Abram, but thy name shall be Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee. Glory be to God. Continue. And I'll make thee exceedingly fruitful, and I'll make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee, and thy seed, singular, and thy seed after thee in the other generations for an everlasting covenant to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. And I will give unto thee and unto thy seed the land wherein thou art a stranger. And all the land of Canaan for an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And God said unto Abraham, now he did not start using Abraham again. Immediately the change of his name, God started using what? Abraham. Thou shalt keep my covenant, therefore, thou and thy seed, after thee in their generations. This is my covenant which ye shall keep between me and you, thy seed after thee, every man child among you shall be circumcised. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Are we getting somewhere, church? God is talking about circumcision here. Genesis 12 was the justification of Abraham. He was called, and that was justification. Then Genesis 15, he was sanctified. That was sanctification. In Genesis 17, there is going to be what? A circumcision. And ye shall circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be a token of the covenant between me and you. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And he that is 8 days old shall be circumcised among you, Every man child in your generation, he that is born in the house or bought with money of any stranger, which is not of thy seed. Amen. Now jump to verse 15. And God said unto Abraham, as for Sarai, thy wife, thou shalt not call her name Sarai again, but Sarah shall her name be. Are we learning something here, church? Amen and amen. And I will bless her and give her, thee a son, also of her. Yea, I will bless her, and she shall be a mother of nations. Kings of people shall be of her. Then Abraham fell upon his face and laughed and said in his heart, shall a child be born unto him that is of 100 years old? And shall Sarah that is 90 years old bear? And Abraham said unto God, oh, that Ishmael might live before thee. And God said, Sarai, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed, and thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant, and with his seed after him. Amen. Church, are we getting along somewhere? Amen. You see, God was doing something here. God brought a covenant of circumcision between him and man. And that was a baptism of the Holy Ghost. Because the baptism of the Holy Ghost is a circumcision. What is circumcision? Circumcision is cutting away the extra flesh. And the baptism of the Holy Ghost is cutting away the extra flesh of the heart. Cutting away the desires of the things of the world. That is what the baptism of the Holy Ghost does. Oh, I believe on the Lord. Praise the Lord. You are justified. We are justified by faith. He was raised on our third day for our justification. But that is not the end of it. If you are justified, then you must be sanctified. We have been washed by the blood of the Lamb. That is not the end of it. If you are sanctified, then you must be what? Filled with the Holy Ghost. So the life of Abraham times the life of the church. Amen. The prophet preached a message, Israel and the church. Without Abraham, there is no Christianity. Amen. Praise be the name of the Lord. Now what happened? He had to what? Change their name. It was Abraham. But there was part of God that was added to him. Ham. Ham is part of God. Ham comes from the word Elohim. Was added to his name from Abraham to Abraham. And when you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you are no more of the old nature. Amen. Hallelujah. You can't be a Catholic when you receive the Holy Ghost. You are no more a Presbyterian when you receive the Holy Ghost. Because you have received a change of name. Amen. And before the blessings must come, there must be a circumcision. Part of you must be taken away, and part of God must be added unto you. Oh, glory, hallelujah. How many will say, God, circumcise me in these 8 days, please? Hallelujah. Lord, take away extra flesh from me. Take away the desires of the things of the world from me. Hallelujah. And give me the part of you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. So in Genesis 17, Abraham received the baptism of the Holy Ghost by a change of name, and he received parts of the name of God. From Abraham to Abraham. Now let us go to verse 1 in Genesis chapter 17. I want to see how God introduced himself to Abraham. And when Abraham was 90 years old and nine. In other words, 99 years old. The Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. That was a time Abraham was weak in flesh. But the prophet of God said, the word I am the Almighty God, the meaning of the Almighty means El Shaddai. He said Shaddai means one breast. So now El Shaddai means two breasts. He said this is a part of the Bible where God identifies himself as a feminine. Oh, praise the Lord. So when God said, I am El Shaddai, in other words, he appeared himself to Abraham at his weakest stage, and he told Abraham, I am your strength giver. I am your all sufficiency. I am the sustainer of your life. Saints of God, if you are getting weak in your Christian journey, tonight he is El Shaddai. He is your strength giver. If you are stumbled on your Christian journey, do not give up. He is your El Shaddai. The great breasted one. What is an El Shaddai? The prophet made an example with a little baby, our nursing mothers. When your baby is fretting, crying, and doing all that, you cannot put him to sleep or quiet him. He said, just pull him towards your bosom and allow that baby to suck. And as the little baby begin to suck, as he begin to cry and suck, it begins to quieten down. What was that? It has received strength from the mother. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. And the child has no other way to receive an attention from his mother than to cry. And as children of God, the only way to receive strength from God is to cry unto him. The Lord, you are my El Shaddai. You are my strength giver. You are the great breasted one. And the prophet of God said, one breast is from the Old Testament, one breast type the New Testament. Oh, he said that breast stands for Psalm 103, that he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. Hallelujah. What happened? He said, I am the Lord that forgiveth thy iniquity and healed all thy diseases. Some children will be sucking this breast, and they will later they will get full, they will still turn to this breast. They are sucking strength. So the same covenant that was atoning for your sin, that same day, that same hour, that same covenant atoned for your sicknesses. Are we together, church? Those watching online, are you together? He was wounded for your transgression. He was bruised for your iniquity. The chastisement of your peace was upon him, and by his stripes ye were healed. Hallelujah. And he is still healing. Jesus saves and Jesus heals. Jesus saves and Jesus delivers. Hallelujah. So one of the breasts was for the forgiveness of our sin, and one was for the healing of our body. Praise be the name of the Lord. He is the El Shaddai. Oh, walk before me and be thou perfect. Your perfection is not of yourself. Your perfection is in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are not perfect in ourselves. We are perfected in him. Oh, glory, hallelujah. He is the El Shaddai. Now let us read from Romans chapter 4. Remember, Abraham believed on the Lord, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Praise be the name of the Lord. What shall we say then? That Abraham, our father, as pertaining to the flesh, has found. Remember, Abraham believed on the Lord, and it was counted unto him as righteousness. Are you together? But yet, even though he believed on the Lord, and it was counted for him for righteousness, he still received the seal of circumcision. Oh, church, can you say amen?
Amen.
So, what shall we say Abraham, our father, has found? For if Abraham were justified by works, he had wherefore to glory, but not before God.
Amen.
Continue. For what saith the scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. That's great. Praise be the name of the Lord. Now continue. Now to him that worketh is the reward not reckoned of grace, but of debt. But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justified ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness.
Amen.
Continue. Even as David described the blessedness of a man, unto him God imputed righteousness without works. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. Saying, blessed are they whose iniquities are forgiven and whose sins are covered. Let me say something here. Okay, I will say it after this one. Blessed is the man to whom the Lord will not impute sin. Listen carefully. The scripture did not say that blessed is the man who did not commit sin. But blessed is a man whom the Lord will not impute sin. And Brother Abraham came to tell us that a righteous man is a sinless man. A righteous man is not a sinless man. Are we together? Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. It shows that it is not our self-righteousness. Hallelujah. But our righteousness is in him. And we are justified by faith, not by works. Blessed is a man to whom the Lord will not impute sin. A righteous man is not a sinless man. Continue. Cometh this blessedness then upon the circumcision only, or upon the uncircumcision also? For we said that faith was reckoned to Abraham for righteousness. How was it then reckoned? When he was in circumcision or in uncircumcision? Not in circumcision, but in uncircumcision. Before he was given a sign of circumcision, it was counted for him for righteousness because he believed on the Lord. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. And he received the sign of circumcision as a seal of righteousness of faith, which he had yet been uncircumcised. Oh. That he might be father of all them that believe, though they be not uncircumcised. They be not circumcised. That the righteousness might be imputed unto them also. Salvation is not Christ plus works. Salvation is Christ and Christ alone. Salvation is not Christ and works. Salvation is of the Lord. There is nothing you did to inherit your salvation. There is nothing you did to deserve your salvation.
Amen.
Salvation is of the Lord.
Amen.
And the father of circumcision to them who are not of circumcision, only but who also walk in the steps of faith of our father Abraham, which he had been yet uncircumcised. For the promise that he should be the heir of the world was not to Abraham or to his seed through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. Saints of God, for if they which are of the law be heirs, faith is made void, and the promise made of none effect. People think they go to church on Saturday is what saves them. Going to church on Saturday does not make you a Christian. Your salvation does not mean you not eating pork or meat. That has nothing to do with your salvation. See, there is difference between what James saw and what Paul saw. The theologians have made confusion about this. One saw the faith of Abraham between God, and one saw the faith of Abraham between the people. They never contradict himself. What Paul was talking here was the faith of Abraham before God. Because God does not see your works. God sees your heart. Abraham believed God. It was counted unto him for righteousness. Now let us go to James. James chapter 2, verse 17 to 26. And bring it together. And it will look like the scripture is contradicting himself. No, sir. The scriptures is not contradicting himself. God sees your heart, but man does not also see your heart. Man sees your works. So even though Abraham believed on the Lord and was counted on him for righteousness, that was not enough. He received a seal of circumcision. James. James chapter 2, verse 17 to 26. He received a seal of circumcision. For the people who does not see your heart to see your works. Because your works prove what is in your heart. You can't see your heart, but your works. Works is faith expressed. Oh, praise the Lord. Even so, faith. If it had not works, he's dead. Being alone. Yea, a man may say, thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without works, and I will show thee my faith by my works. Thou believest that there is one God that does well, the devil also believe and tremble. Thank God, and he trembled. But would thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead? Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he had offered Isaac his son up the altar? Seest thou how faith wrought with his works, and by works was made perfect. And the scripture was fulfilled, which said Abraham believed God, and it was imputed unto him for righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. You see then how that by works a man is justified and not by faith only. Oh, glory. Likewise also, was not Rahab the harlot justified by works when she had received the messengers and had sent them unto another way? Continue. For as a body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also. These scriptures might look contradictory, but by the revelation of the message of the hour, it's not contradicting. One is a faith between Abraham and God, and one was a faith between Abraham and the people. Because God does not see your works. God sees your heart. And the people can see your heart, they also see your works. Praise be the name of the Lord. Are we together? So, the rare seed of Abraham is not Isaac. Neither Ishmael. Abraham have two sons, Isaac and Ishmael. Even after Sarah died, he married Keturah and have 12 more children. But the Bible is talking about a seed. Are we together, church? The seed of Abraham is the faith of Abraham. And the royal seed of Abraham is our Lord Jesus Christ. time will not permit us. We saw the natural seed of Abraham in action. The Jews boast that they are of the seed of Abraham. But Jesus told them, every one of you were dead in the wilderness. Are you greater than our father Abraham? He said, Abraham rejoiced to see my day. Now, God had a plan and a purpose to bring the Gentiles in redemption. And the purpose and the plan of God to bring the Gentiles in redemption is by marriage. Moses married Zipporah. Zipporah was a Gentile. Are we together, church? Salmon, we read about Rahab. He married a Gentile prostitute who was Rahab. And out of that lineage came also Boaz. And he married Ruth, a Gentile. And her name is even in the Bible. It was foreshadowing Christ and a bride. That Christ will one day take a Gentile bride. Are we together, church? Are we together? Amen. Are we getting somewhere, church? Amen. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. In Genesis chapter 18, Abraham received a visitation. And one day around 11 to 12, the prophet said, he saw three men passing by. And when Abraham saw them, and they greeted, and they make as if they are passing by. He said, no, let me wash your feet and refresh you. Because Abraham realized one of them was God. Glory. But they were in men clothing. Hallelujah. There were three people, but he bowed before one and said, my Lord. Oh, hallelujah. These same people went to Sodom. And Lord saw them and said, my Lords. When you look, what did you see? Look. Another word for look is behold. When you look, what did you see? Once or three, he said, my Lord. Once or two, he said, my Lords. That was God in flesh that visited Abraham because the time came for that promised word to be made manifest. And when Abraham heard the shalom, he knew that there was something about that voice. That I've been hearing a voice in the skies all this while. But now, this man, the way he's greeting, it looks as if it's the voice that I've been hearing all this while. Oh, praise the Lord. Job said, I have heard, but now I see. Brethren, the problem we have around the ranks of this message is that we are only hearing without seeing. Until your hearing becomes your seeing, you will never doubt the prophet. Until your word, your hearing becomes your seeing, you will not struggle to believe. Hallelujah. Because to see is to understand. As you are preaching, everybody is hearing. But how many are seeing? Everybody is hearing, but how many are understanding? There was a man came, and he was a man, but that was God in the flesh. They killed a calf, they served them, and the man turned his back. Said, why did Sarah laugh? How did he know? There are three races of people. There are three classes of people. We have the Jews, the Samaritans, and the Gentiles. When Christ came, he revealed himself to the Jews. He revealed himself to the Samaritans. John 4. And in Luke chapter, 3. Luke chapter 2 verse 30. He said, even thus in the days when the Son of Man shall be revealed, the Son of Man will be revealed in the flesh again. Now, here is a secret. What God did to Abraham. By discernment, what God did to Abraham in these last days, God did through Abraham. Are we together, church? In the days of Abraham, there were two human beings, two different entities. But in these last days, there is another man on the scene with his name Ham, part of God. And what God did to Abraham, this time he did not do to Abraham, but he did through Abraham's ministry. To reveal the messianic sign, to discern our heart, to give us faith for the promised land.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory be to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. What a message. Hallelujah. There is something going on within me. Because what happens, righteous faith lies within the messages. Doubt must be taken away from Sarah in order to receive faith to produce the promise of Isaac. Then when they had the visitation, the other two men went to Sodom. And Sodom stunned the world. Because the Bible said in Luke 17:30, as it was in the days of Sodom, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be. What happened there? He went to Sodom, and Sodom is the condition of the age we find ourselves here. Where homosexuals are everywhere. Oh, my God. And those two messengers also preach a message, and they preach a blinding message. And it blinded them to the door. I am the door. Amen and amen. And we saw the ministry of William Branham on the scene with the elected church, which is Abraham. And we saw Oral Roberts and Billy Graham's ministry to the world. Thank you, Jesus. Are we together, church? Now, before Sodom can be burned, Abraham had a secret. Can I hide anything from Abraham, my friend? God in flesh gave a revelation to Abraham that the church in Sodom has no idea. Brethren, what we are feasting upon and rejoicing upon, the people of the world have no idea. God bless you, my brother. You caught a fire down there. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. You see, let me come to the critics of the message. In Genesis chapter 20, Sodom was destroyed in Genesis 19. In Genesis 20, Abraham met Abimelech. He said, who is this? He said, oh, he's my sister. In some way, Sarah was his sister because Sarah was a half-sister. But in a reality, that was his wife. So, in a normal sentence, Abraham lied. But at night, when the king was getting himself ready, God said, you are like a dead man. Restore the man his wife. Sir, sir, he lied to me, he's a sister. He said, that is my prophet. Take the wife back and let him pray for you. Are we seeing two things here? Amen. The man said, by works, he lied to him. But God said, he's my prophet.
Amen.
The problem we are seeing today with those so-called ex-believers that we have them around in this country, one is seeing the works of a fleshly man, and one is also seeing a God-ordained servant. So either you accept him as a prophet of God, or you look at the mistake of a man.
That's right.
The man lied, but God said he's my prophet. I don't care what I believe the sign might say or all those sight might say, I believe the prophet of God. Hallelujah. And I'm not ashamed to identify with his message. Hallelujah. I am believing him because of the ministry of Christ in him, not because of his fleshly works. God said, he's my prophet.
That's right.
How dare you correct the servant of God? It is God that corrects his servant.
Amen.
It is God that called them. And God knows where to pin them. Amen. And the prophet made a mistake and he made him. And so what? What has that got to do with me? Yes, he's a man. He's hard to make mistake. He's not God. He's a man and he has to make mistake. Hallelujah. But one thing that concerned me, he brought the voice of God in this generation. Hallelujah. Regardless of his mistake, we saw the mighty God unveil before us. Hallelujah. That is what we care. Praise be the name of the Lord. Oh, glory, hallelujah. A righteous man is not a sinless man. Then in Genesis 21, the birth of Isaac. Oh, glory be to God. Isaac was born. Sarah rejoiced. Then Ishmael began to mock at Isaac. Then Sarah told Abraham, take away the bondswoman and the child. For my child is a child of the promise. Will not be here with the shock. Right. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. Amen. Time will not permit us. Then in Genesis 22, when the promised child came, in Genesis 22, the faith of Abraham was tested. You can imagine, after waiting on God for 25 years, and the promise have come, and the child is now 13 years, God said, go and crucify him for me. Oh, my God, my Lord. Let us read from verse 9 to 18. Genesis 22, verse 9 to 18. And they came to a place which God had told him of. And Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar upon the wood. It was a prefigure of Jesus Christ. Amen. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, yeah, I am. And he said, lay not thy hand upon the Lord, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son from me. But there was Ishmael. But God recognized only Isaac. Hallelujah! Thy only son from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horn. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered up him for a burnt offering instead of his son. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh. As he said, to this day, the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, by myself have I sworn, see the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, that in blessing will I bless thee, and in multiply will I multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemy. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. You see this blessing that God pronounces upon him and his seed. In verse 17, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed and the stars of the heaven and as the sun upon the seashore, and thy seed, singular, shall possess the gate of his enemy. When Rebekah was going to marry, open to Genesis 24, verse 60, which is supposed to be the wife of the seed of Abraham, Isaac, strangely, when his parents were blessing her, verse 60, they said, and they blessed Rebekah and said unto her, that art our sister. Be thou the mother of thousands of millions, and let thy seed possess the gate of those which hate them. In other words, the wife-to-be of Abraham's son received the same blessing that his husband-to-be has received. Oh, glory, hallelujah. And thy seed shall possess the gate of thy enemy. Now, the question comes in closing. What is our enemy? Oh, praise be the name of the Lord. Will you mind to turn to 1 Corinthians? 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 26. Our last enemy. What is our last enemy? The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. See, all the natural seed of Abraham, Moses, Jeremiah, Isaiah, they were great Gentile warriors. Oh, Gideon, time will fail me to mention something. But they were all put down by that last enemy, which is death. And that is our last enemy. Are we together, church? So now we have seen what our last enemy is, right? Now that same scripture, just jump to 51 to 56. Behold, I will show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. Glory, hallelujah. What a promise. What a consolation. I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. The Bible didn't even use the physical word die. But we shall not all sleep. It goes to show us a Christian does not die. Christians sleep in the Lord. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. Oh, glory. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, death, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. Let me have a little demonstration for the kids here.
Let's go to this thing.
But thanks be to God, which gave us victory through Christ our Lord Jesus. I want to give this little demonstration that we can close. The prophet of God said, the sting of death is like a beast that buzzes. So when he saw Moses, put him by death. So Joshua, put him by death. And as it goes around, he came to the cross on the Golgotha. He was making that noise we are hearing here. He made that buzz of noise. Hey, do you know me? I am dead. I can put you to the grave. But little did he know that this was a man who is able to put down his body and is able to take it back in 3 days. Hallelujah! So as he was going, he was just looking at him. Then he finally now stung him. And when the stung of sin, oh glory, the sting of death stung him, the prophet of God demonstrated to say that every person that he stings, he takes back and go and seek another one. But that day, he had the last sting. When he was pulling, the sting was not pulling. Oh, glory. Death was swallowed up in victory. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! It broke in there. That was the last thing he had. And the devil think he has got him. And he laid him in the grave. Oh, but even in the grave, he is Lord. Hallelujah! And on the third day, when he descended, he led the captivity captive. He went to the eastern gate. And he shouted, oh, be open. Ye everlasting gate, be thou open. Now listen carefully. The prophet of God said when he was knocking,
Some little demons came to see, who is at the door? He said, I'm Jesus. Go and tell your master I'm here. And these little demons went to the devil. There is a guy knocking at the door. He said, who is he? He said, he's Jesus. And the devil began to shake. Don't mention that name here again. And he went to the door. Who is he? He said, I am the Lord of hosts. Open ye the everlasting gate. And the devil was shaking. And he gave him the keys of death, the keys of hell, the keys of the grave. And he said, as they were conversing, Abraham and Sarah was also behind. And they were looking at their show. He said, who is that man, honey? It looks like the man who turned his back to the tent and told me what is in my heart. Ezekiel, look at him. He looked like the real in the real. The prophet of God said, every one of them saw him the way they preach him. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. Every one of them saw him the way they preach him. They begin to call themselves, it's a jubilee time. Hallelujah. They were having a revival day. And he opened the door of death and grave. So you come up here, let us go to Jerusalem. What was that? That was the seed of Abraham possessing the gate of our enemy, which is death. So our Lord Jesus possessed the gate of death. He possessed the gate of sicknesses. He possessed the gate of the grave. He possessed the gate of hell. And tonight he is standing among us as a mighty conqueror. And thy seed shall possess the gate of thy enemies. Sickness is not me to possess. He has already possessed it. By his stripe, I am healed. Hallelujah. What do you think that Paul will look in the face of death? Can you go up again? Maybe verse 56, yes. Or no, 55. Go up a little. He said, oh, death, where is thy sting? Because Paul knows the secret that you know. Amen. That death is swallowed up in victory. Amen. Oh, grave, where is thy victory? Oh, glory, hallelujah. Where is thy victory, oh, grave? What confidence did he have? Because he had the hope of resurrection. Through the Holy Spirit, through the message of our day, we are now the royal seed of Abraham. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Church, come. As the musicians resume their seat, for all things are ready. This is your promise. The seed of Abraham, they were promise of blessings. The blessings or the promise of the blessedness is the Holy Spirit. And they were promised for a land to inherit. Their promised land is our promised word. Hallelujah. Their promised land is our promised word. Brethren, we are blessed beyond measure to know these things. So the royal seed of Abraham, the royal seed of Abraham is our Lord Jesus Christ. And being part of the groom, through the Holy Spirit, we are more than conquerors. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. These are the exceeding great promises he had in store for us. In this 8 days feast, please, recognize who you are in the Lord. Recognize this day and his messages. We have seen the path of God in our day. I'm back again. God manifested himself through the prophet. And that did not end there. God wants to manifest himself through your bodies. We want to be a living monument of the living God. Hallelujah. We want to manifest God in Ottawa, in India, in Africa, in everywhere. We want the beauty of Jesus Christ be seen in us. As the musicians play, let the beauty of Jesus Christ be seen in us. Shall we be on our feet?
Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Let the beauty of Jesus Christ be seen in us. Hallelujah.
The beauty of Jesus be seen. Oh, wonderful passion and purity. Spirit divine, all my nature refined. The beauty of Jesus be seen in me.
Hymn number 75. Let the beauty of Jesus.
Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in me. Oh, wonderful passion and purity. Oh, the Spirit divine of my nature refined.
Hallelujah.
The beauty of Jesus be seen.
One more time.
Oh, let the beauty of Jesus be seen.
Hallelujah.
In me.
Let's sing it one more time. Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in me. Oh, His wonderful passion and hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. How many feel blessed by the word of God? Hallelujah. Lord, we bless your holy name. Let's all pray for a moment. Wonderful passion and purity. Spirit divine, all my nature refined, take the beauty of Jesus be seen. Amen. How many seed of Abraham I hear this night and on the line, seed of the royal seed of Abraham, amen, being a part of God. God manifesting himself through us, amen. Why? The work is complete, amen. The work is already done. We just want to thank Apostle for this marvelous revelation that God has given to him for us tonight, amen. Sweet Redeemer, all my nature refined. Beauty of Jesus be seen. Amen. I want us to switch to key G. Hallelujah. The kingdom. Maria, help me quick. Hallelujah. The kingdom. Hallelujah. Jesus, God's righteousness revealed. The Son of Man, the Son of God, His kingdom come. Jesus, redemption sacrifice, now glorify, now testify, His kingdom come. And His kingdom will know no end, His glory shall know no bound. And power of this kingdom's King has come, and this kingdom's rule, and this kingdom's power and authority. Jesus, God's right. Righteousness revealed. Jesus, the expression of God's love, the grace of God, the Word of God revealed to us. God's holiness displayed, now glorified, now justified, His kingdom come, and His kingdom will know no end, and His glory shall not. For the majesty and power of this kingdom's King has come, and this kingdom's growing, and this kingdom's rule, and this kingdom's power and authority. God's righteousness revealed, and His kingdom will know no end. Hallelujah. And His glory shall know no bound. For the majesty and power of this kingdom's King has come. And this kingdom's reign, and this righteousness. Breathe. Continue to play it. How many here believe that you are a part of the seed of Abraham? God said that thy seed shall possess the gates of his enemies. Hallelujah. That's what authority. That's power given by God to every seed of Abraham. Hallelujah. That's what we've heard. The victory is already won. Hallelujah. And by faith we claim that promise and we lay a hold upon it. And God has already finished the work for us. Is that right? That's right. That means that that covenant that was entered into, as our brother said to us, the birds were not divided. Divine healing lays within the two covenants. Is that right? That means it belongs to us tonight. That means all things are possible to them that will dare to believe God. Hallelujah. Somebody believe God this very moment. And then take your blessings and walk away. Amen. Rejoicing in the presence of God. It belongs to you. It's yours. Why? He purchased it for us. And there is no enough devils in hell to be able to prevent you from taking a hold of the promise of God and seeing results come out of it. Is that right? How many believe it? Glory be to Jesus Christ. Look, the anointing of God is in the room here. I'll tell you in the name of Jesus Christ. That's true. The power of God is present. Amen. God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ever think of, according to his great promise that he has made to us. Amen. Because what? We are the seed of Abraham. We are part of him. Amen. All things belong to us. Hallelujah. We are not just little bitty people that are orphans. We are heirs of salvation. We are heirs of the promises of God. It belongs to us. And I want you to believe it. Throughout these global revival prayer meetings, we've been praying, believing God, a God will heal the sick, God will save the lost, God will touch lives and fill the people with the Holy Spirit of promise. Hallelujah. And this great Jehovah God, I believe with all my heart, has been expressed to us through the word that has been preached to us tonight. Now, the sons of Abraham, the seed of Abraham that is in here, I call upon you to believe God now. Hallelujah. That's right. And his kingdom's reign, and his kingdom's power and authority. Jesus, God's righteousness reveal, and his kingdom will know no end, and his glory shall know no bound. For the majesty and power of this kingdom's king has come, and his kingdom's reign, and his kingdom's rule, and his kingdom's power and authority. Jesus, God's righteousness revealed. There are some needs that we have received from by way of email. We're going to pray over them. How many believe that God is going to give it to them? Absolutely, 100% God is going to grant it. Amen. Who is Rosie? Is it Rosie here? Rosie is starting school class tomorrow. Need some prayer. Amen. Wherever you are, Rosie. All right. Glory be to Jesus Christ. God is going to bless Rosie. Raise your hand to God. Rosie. Raise your hand. Come on. Let's. God's grace come upon little Rosie. See, out of the mouths of babes, God has ordained strength. Think in your heart again. You want Jesus to bless you, Rosie? God is going to bless you. Amen. Apostle, just lay your hands upon the young little believer who believes in Jesus Christ, that God will bless her studies. Amen. God Almighty, let's all pray. Well, Lord, your servant has just laid his hands upon the little lad who is believing you that you grant to her victory in her studies right this very moment. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that the heavens will be open unto little Rosie, that all God wisdom and understanding be given to her, that she will excel, Lord God, in her studies in the name of Jesus Christ. Anybody here that is also believing God, a God who bless your studies, raise up your hand. That I believe like little Rosie. Amen. I see hands. God Almighty, while these hands are up, believing you that you're going to touch them, Father, and you're going to bless them. You're going to open the door for them to receive breakthroughs in their studies. God, I pray in Jesus' name that this semester will be a special time for them, God, that they will have such supernatural wisdom and understanding that will come to them, that they will begin to excel in everything that they study in the schools for the glory of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory. Now we are going to pray and lift Pastor Dominic's family back home. They're going to be traveling. Pastor is here. The wife is going to be traveling to a convention. And he's asking for traveling mercies for the entire family. So we lift Sister Ruth and the whole family into the hands of the Lord. That God will protect them and give them traveling mercies. Let's all pray. Everyone in the sanctuary and on the line. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, we lift Pastor Dominic into your hands as he is asking for this intervention by the hand of Jesus Christ, Lord, upon his family who will be traveling, that you grant to them traveling mercies, keep them safe, oh Jehovah God, and give them a wonderful time as they go for that revival. May the grace of Jesus Christ prevail over them, Father. Bring them back home safely in Jesus' mighty name. Glory. Hallelujah. There's a request here coming from Brother Wayswan Jackson, I believe in Uganda. And he's a pastor. And they've run into some really serious financial issues. To live in the building of the church, the property of the church would have to be sold in order to deal with these financial pressure that they have come under. We're going to ask God to make a supernatural provision for this particular pastor and his congregation to spare the church from this agony. How many believe God is able to do it? Hallelujah. Well, let's all pray for the Pastor Wayswa Jackson, that God will divinely intervene for him. Lord Jesus, we are lifting Pastor Wayswa Jackson of Uganda into your hands, Father. We are asking for a divine intervention for him, Father, that you will find a way, unexpected sources to help them deal with the financial challenges that the church has gone through, that they'll be able to pay the bills and not be forced to sell the church or the land for the church, Father. God, you granted a place to them, and you will help them to be good stewards of these blessings that you've given to them. So, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name that you will send a helping hand to them, Lord. Supernaturally touch somebody's heart. Oh, Jehovah God, to send them a helping hand to spare the saints in Uganda, in that part of the world. Bless them, Father. Help them intervene for them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Continue to pray. Continue to pray. Everybody pray for this precious pastor as we call upon the name of Jesus Christ for him. Hallelujah. Lord, help us. Amen. I can't even open my computer. Oh, somebody help me out here. Darren, tap it up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Tap it up and open it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Look, there's some other request here. Amen. This is, he said, today, my son, Arnold John Joshua Matanji's birthday. He said, remember him in prayer. This is coming from Pastor Joshua Matanji, who has been translating for us for many years now. And his son, I see his picture here, needs a blessings from God. Why? He too is a seed of Abraham. Hallelujah. And he's also a part of the blessings of God. So let's all raise up our voices to Jehovah God and ask for a blessing over Joel Joshua Matanji. Lord Jesus, we are lifting Joshua Matanji, Pastor Matanji's son Joel. Lord, today is his birthday. Lord God, send a helping hand to him. Pour special blessings upon him, Father. May his path be watered by the word of the living God. May God, the grace of Jesus Christ, descend upon him, Father, that the love of Jesus Christ will fill his heart and the Holy Spirit of God will come upon him and baptize him, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, that he will see the glory of God. Lord, we bless your holy name, Father, for this grace upon him. In Jesus' mighty name, we give you thanks and we give you praise. Amen. Righteousness. Lord, I offer my life to you. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, oh, use it for your glory. And Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise. Oh, as a pleasing sacrifice. Oh, Lord, I offer you my life. One more time. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, oh, use it for your glory. And Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Oh Lord, I offer you my life. All that I am, all that I have, I lay them down before you. Oh Lord, all my regrets, all my claims, my joy and the kingdom, your. Raise up your hands to Jesus. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, oh, use it for your glory. And Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you. Oh, as a pleasing sacrifice, Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. Oh, my all my love, my hands, my heart and my hands, I make it through. Lord, I
for your glory. And Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life.
I'm going to invite Pastor Fenafay of Quebec City, who will be preaching for us tomorrow at day number 5, to come and give us a closing prayer. Let's welcome Pastor Fenafay to come and give us a closing prayer. He's here with his precious wife, Sister Michelle, and we love him very much. God bless Pastor Fay. Hallelujah.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this meeting, for the word that was preached to us. It was not a man preaching to us, but your Holy Spirit. It was Christ calling us, and Christ willing that we know that we are the royal seed of Abraham in you, because you are this royal seed of Abraham, and it's only in you that we can be that seed. Blessed be your name, Lord, for this great time of refreshing, for this great time when you are here among your people, working in the souls, in the bodies, in the spirits of your people. And we know that the seed of God will possess the gates of all his enemies, even the last enemy, death. Victory is already ours in you, Lord Jesus Christ. Bless everyone who was present in this meeting, in this congregation, and all the people online, and let the Holy Spirit works after the service. You are still working in each of one of us. Let your Holy Spirit just bring us this desire that you, Lord Jesus Christ, you will be seen through us by your Spirit in us. In Jesus Christ's name, bless everybody. Keep everybody in peace and in your under your grace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen and amen. Hallelujah. How many feel blessed by God? Amen. I want to thank the ministers and the churches of the line. So if you can project them while I call their name. Pastor Joshua Singh. Amen. God bless you. Pastor Lola Skujo. God bless you. Pastor Akram Roshan, God bless you. Pastor Jose Garcia, God bless you. Pastor Prabhuda Stambi, God bless you. Pastor BP Mishra, God bless you. Pastor Deepak Abraham, God bless you. Pastor John Kaki, God bless you. Pastor Hazel Coker, God bless you. I see Pastor Daniel Passos, God bless you. Associate Pastor Joseph Torres, God bless you. Pastor Rajendra Kujo, God bless you. And then Pastor Ronnie Milieva, God bless you. Pastor Nolan Dominic, God bless you. Pastor Steve Brisson, God bless you. Apostle Isaac, what a message, what a message. Pastor Gonzalez, God bless you. Pastor Fenafay, God bless you. Hallelujah. And let's recognize the nations that are represented here. We've got India, France, Germany, Pakistan, Philippines, South Africa, Tanzania, Venezuela, Canada. And then there are churches that are listening in for this message. Think in your heart again. The Bright Church of Pakistan, the Live Tabernacle, the Revival Word Fellowship in India, the Albin Katob Church, Eaglets Fellowship in India, Living Waters Tabernacle, Apostolic Spiritual Church in Kathmandu, Nepal. Hallelujah. Jatsigoth Church in India and Little Flock Tabernacle, amen, in Kitchener. Glory be to God. Now I want to recognize our translators, Brother Neville, God bless you, for French. Brother Samuel for German. Philip Tambe for Hindi. Brother Martin for Nyanja. Brother Torres for Spanish. Brother Paul Johanna for Swahili. And Brother Deepak for Telugu. And Brother Azal for Urdu. May God bless all his servants who are working so hard around the world to bring forth this glorious message to all the nations of the world. And may the bride rejoice because Jesus is with the bride. Hallelujah. And we thank the Lord God for everybody's life. Let's rise up on our feet and sing one before we close. I am redeemed. How many feel you are redeemed? I am redeemed. Oh, bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody they ask you just who I am, oh, tell them I am redeemed. The seed of Abraham. Sing it again. Oh, I am redeemed. Hallelujah. Bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you, tell who I am, oh, tell. I am redeemed. One more time. Oh, I am redeemed. I'm bought with the blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them I am redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of Jesus. I am redeemed. I'm bought with a price. Oh, Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just who I am, everyone, I'll see you in the basement for some fellowship. Hallelujah. And tomorrow, 7 o'clock sharp, we start day 5, amen, being preached by Pastor Fenafe. Invite your friends and loved ones and come early, and let's enjoy the word of God again. Amen. God bless you. We love you very much. We are dismissed. Oh, if anybody asked you, oh, just who I am. Tell them I am redeemed. Oh, I am redeemed. Bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. Amen. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them I am redeemed. God bless your heart. Thank you. I am redeemed. I'm bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just